first question. There's no judgment. There's nothing wrong with saying yes or no. It's just a question because I know how touchy this subject can be. But I went to school for Catholic school for 13 years, since pre-K to the end of high school. And I've grown to be agnostic, which basically means you don't know what to believe in because you just don't know. Because in the real world, you don't. No one knows. Even believers don't know. Technically, I don't want to run into anyone's thing, but I mean, come on. So before I start, how many of you believe in God? Charlie, can you describe to me what Jesus looks like?
I don't know. Oh, like what Jesus
what
is like.
He looks like, yeah.
The person. Oh, he's got long hair. I mean, most of the time he's white. Sometimes he has a six-pack.
White,
across.
Long hair, six-pack. I mean, I guess like that's true.
Yeah.
That's true. That's a basic look at Jesus, and that's the classic look. But in reality, Jesus was a historical figure who was real, and that what he looked like, because someone who's born in Bethlehem is actually modern-day Israel. And someone who's born in modern-day Israel is not going to look like a white guy with long hair and a six-pack. And this picture is by BBC, and all this information I found on BBC. So I think that it's okay to think of Jesus as however you want, as a good-looking white man with long hair that a lot of people seem to look up to, but I feel like the U.S., when the new U.S. Christian Catholic Bible was written, I think that we kind of fabricated it a little bit, and we thought of Jesus as someone that we need to look up to as like one of miracle worker who also is a male model. And really, it's this, and that is a confirmed, not confirmed, but a accurate representation of what Jesus looked like. On. Jesus and Mary Magdalene could have been secret lovers. Now, this is a theory, but it's something that can make someone think differently about the Catholic Church itself. Now, Mary Magdalene was a prostitute back in the time, you know, 32 years or so that Jesus was born. I don't know the exact year she was born. Jesus rescued her from seven devils, quote unquote, and she was said to be the woman who walked with the Lord through her whole life. Now, she was definitely the one who was closest to Jesus throughout his whole life. And when they say walked with the Lord, that sounds like someone that was very, very, very close. And that also, quite frankly, does sound like just a old girlfriend that has a fancy name to it. One that walked with the Lord. Someone that was with Jesus the whole time. And is a woman. And was a prostitute. Now, I know that sounds very non-believable, but if you look here, this picture by Leonardo da Vinci, I don't know when it was released. It was years and hundreds of years after Jesus' death. And right here is Mary Magdalene, and these are all of the disciples. Now, when Leonardo da Vinci released this picture, or this painting, he was already famous. So it's said to be that the Catholic Church reached out to him and said, we don't want Mary Magdalene to be close to Jesus as looking like a lover in this picture. So they wanted him to make it seem like Mary Magdalene was just an acquaintance. So they had her lean away towards, I'm not sure if that's John or Peter, I'm not sure, that I really don't know, but towards one of the other disciples to make it look like they weren't in love. And it seems like sort of a bribery to cover up possibly what could have been a bloodline of Christ. And down here it says Merovingian kings, and it's kind of hard to pronounce, but that was the supposed dynasty that Jesus' bloodline from Mary Magdalene ran off to and became. And one child of Jesus and Mary Magdalene ran off to modern-day France with Mary Magdalene after Jesus' death. And became a ruler of Merovingian kings, and it's very hard to pronounce, but those people, Merovingian kings, if you do research, they were hated, and they were not looked right upon, and which is kind of ironic, because it's a descendant. what this means is that if that's true, then there is a person alive today who is in the bloodline of Christ. The Pope is not infallible. This means that infallible means that the Pope can't fail, and it seems like that's kind of fabricated as well, because if everyone's born with original sin, all of a sudden we elect somebody who's technically in another line of Christ, not bloodline, but just a ruling line of Christ, and all of a sudden he's infallible, which means he can't fail. That's kind of contradictory to saying everyone's born with original sin except for Jesus and Mary. The curtain in the temple was an add-on to the North American version of the Bible. The second, it supposedly said that the second life left Jesus' body on the cross, that a temple in the curtain in Jerusalem, this is the temple in Jerusalem in the Bible, we don't know which temple, it tore in half rapidly. No one knows how. And if it's an add-on to the North American version, it says it might be the King James version as well, but I've heard more about North American. Well, I don't know why that would have to be added in there, what such a weird detail, but crucifixion is not portrayed correctly. It's actually, Jesus doesn't carry his whole cross. He only carries the beam that his arms would have been on, but like this, tied with rope around his wrists. And when you see Jesus carrying animations or maybe real life movies, this was the Passion of Christ that he carried. It's supposed to be beamed. And I don't know why that was a thing of carrying the whole cross and, you know, the media, but it was really just the beam. And I know that's not a big detail, but it's something to look at on why they made Jesus' crucifixion different from all the other criminals back then. And this is from Bible Commentary and Matthew Henry's Bible Commentary. And to finish, why is any of this relevant? Well, when we look at everyone's religion, and this is why I'm agnostic as of right now, and I really do wish that I could find something to make myself believe, but when we look at Buddhism and Hinduism and other religions, such as, you know, anything but the Catholic Church, everyone here who believes in God at one point thought, that's a weird, you know, why are they believing in the wheel of samsara, which is something that the Hindus believe in? Like, what is that? You know, it's a life wheel that'll take you to the afterlife, you know, and you think, wow, what? People have always poked holes in other religions that they're not a part of, but look at all the holes that I just poked into Christianity. And what I want to prove is that before you look at someone else's religion as inferior to yours, think about all the holes that can be poked into yours, and think about the real world things that can happen that can prove that your religion is just another made-up fantasy, or it's real. But I want everyone to think before judging